Penultimate, the next to the last. That is exactly what Robot on the Road is, being the 34th short in the 35-part series that is the Animator Expo. Being the 34th in the series, I had a pretty established set of expectations that had been developed through getting this far. These expectations were, don't expect a complete or satisfying story, and don't expect great animation, because while there were shorts that had these things, I would say they only made up for a third to half of the shorts in the anthology. So with the expectations set to such a mediocre level, it is actually not that surprising that Robot on the Road was able to rise above my expectations, and do so in a very unexpected way. Robot on the Road is the story of a robot named Robo and his quest to get to Central City in order to have maintenance done by Cyber Dai Dai Corporation. His means of getting there is by hitchhiking, and in the process of doing so, he comes across a woman driving her travel trailer who agrees to take him part of the way there. The woman's name is Mina, a free-spirited traveler who simply drives around with her trusty trailer for reasons that we really aren't given. Robo at first seems like a simply normal artificial intelligence who is very matter-of-fact and polite. This though is a facade for his much more perverted side of him that takes over when no one else is around. Robo in his free time runs an erotic blog where he posts about all his various sexual encounters he's had with the women on his journey. While this kind of peeping Tom type character who over-exaggerates, embellishes, and flat out lies about their sexual conquests is nothing I haven't seen before, I still found the fact that it was being portrayed by a robot to be pretty humorous in itself. And while I do for the most part like more sexually themed works regardless of how trashy they are, there is one thing that elevates Robot on the Road from these simple fan service shows, and that is the production and staff that brought this piece to life. One member of the staff that I would particularly like to give mention to is the man who served as the original creator, scriptwriter, key animator, character designer, animation director, and lead director, Hiroyuki Okiura. Now, I'm not going to go very deep into quite why this man is so important and why so many people, myself included, consider him to be one of the greatest animators of all time. All I'm going to say is that he's one of the very best directors/animators who has ever worked in anime, contributing to works such as Jinro, Akira, Ghost in the Shell, Pat Labor, A Letter to Momo, and so many others. The common thing he pretty much brings to every production that he's involved in is an absolute mastery of animation. I urge you to check out his work if you're just a fan of good animation. So him being connected to this project, by extension, means that it has no shortage of phenomenal animation and compositing. In fact, the production of this piece is so good, they actually published a book containing the production material, including some of the storyboards, key animations and corrections, and even layout designs in it. They did all of this because this piece is just such a collaboration between some of the best talent anime has to offer. And I for one am thankful that they were willing to share such insights into their production, as some anime productions are almost impossible to ascertain any kind of information on outside of what the credits provide. With all of this pretty presentation, the story really feels like it takes a back seat, and it shows. I appreciate that it is concise and doesn't try to be anything more than a simple story that is able to fully resolve in the minutes it had to do so. It lacks originality because of this, and doesn't really push the envelope, but instead it tries to simply make for an enjoyable experience, and boy, do I think it is one. Maybe I'm not mature enough, and I still just find sexual hijinks pretty fun to watch, but that combined with the insane quality of the production, and the fact that it left me satisfied with what I had but craving for more, is honestly the best thing I can hope to get from a short film. Very few shorts that I have seen can achieve this balance that Robot on the Road has done in such a marvelous way, and for that I have to deliver it the recognition it deserves and give it an impressive score of 78%. And with that, it's time for me to head out. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm Holden Casanova. And until next time, sayonara, see you later. Robo by ra ra bamba. Robo by ra ra bamba. Se necessita.